And welcome to this introductory tutorial on MPFB materials. In this video, it is assumed that you have already installed MPFB and at least the system assets pack. If you have not done so, please first watch the Getting Started video. There should be a link in the description. In this video, we will cover the basics of MPFB materials. We will start with the background theory about what a material is in the first place and then provide an overview the different material models available in MPFB. If you already know the background theory of what materials are and understand the difference between image-based materials and procedural materials, then you can skip ahead. The end of the video will consist of more hands-on instructions on how to choose which material model to use, as well as getting more materials. The topic of MPFB materials is pretty large, thus it has been divided into a series of different videos. This is the first part, and the purpose is to provide a basic overview. When working with 3D, the visual appearance of a 3D object largely derives from two different sources. The first and most obvious is the geometry of the mesh, the vertices and the faces. The second is the material. The material is what gives the object's surface its appearance. For example, if you have a red sphere, then sphere is the mesh and red is the material. In the image to the right, you can see the same mesh with and without a material. All the extra effects on the lower sphere are created via various aspects of materials. The color is what you will normally first get to when giving an object its appearance. In 3D lingo, you will sometimes also hear the term diffuse. There's a bit more to it, but if you hear the term diffuse, you can think color. The next natural part is how reflective the surface is. This largely stems from the roughness of the surface. Consider, for example, the difference between a polished marble floor and a bare concrete floor. The marble will be smooth, meaning you can see light reflected on it. The concrete will be rough, meaning you will not see any reflections on it. Going beyond color and roughness, there are other tricks to make the surface appear as if it had a structure. By assigning normals or bump, we can instruct the renderer to draw shadows or light variations on the surface as if there was extra geometry there. In the image to the right, you can see a wavy ridge. This is not mesh geometry, but a bump map where parts of the surface has been set as being raised beyond its natural position, thus creating shadows. Another often used aspect of materials is transparency. In the bottom sphere, I have assigned an area with an alpha value set to 0. Again, it is not a difference in geometry. It is the material that is transparent here. There is a huge set of other things you can do with materials. Blender shader nodes is something that can take years to learn. But these are at least some of the most commonly used aspects. When discussing materials, you will often hear the term procedural in relation to Blender materials. What this means is that it contains more or less complicated logic to control the aspects of the material. This can, for example, be a mathematical function to draw a pattern, or logic for mixing different aspects together. The alternative to procedural materials are image-based materials. Here, you instead use static images to control the aspects of the material. For example, you could have an image with a floral pattern on a dress, and another to control what parts of the surface should be shiny and which should be dull. Note that this separation is not an either-or. In Blender, all materials are in some sense procedural these days, as they are defined via shader nodes. In the dawn of time, Blender had materials which were not nodes-based, but these are long since gone. Most other applications do not use shader nodes, though. Such applications will normally expect image-based materials. There is nothing particularly magic about an MPFB material. It follows the same principles as the ones outlined previously about materials in general. Via MPFB materials, you will get color, roughness, normals, and transparency. What makes them different are that they are adapted and specific for MPFB mesh assets. An important thing one has to realize is that there is not one MPFB material model. There are several, and they work in different ways. They contain different amounts of procedural logic, ranging from the game engine material, which is completely image-based, to the procedural ice, which is completely procedural. The default material model is make skin, and if you do not say otherwise, this is what will be used for everything. It is a mostly image-based material, but with some minor procedural tweaks. The upside of using MakeSkin is that it is simple, efficient, and mostly easy to understand. The downside is you will not get the bells and whistles, which are available in the other material models. Which material you want to use comes down to what you want to achieve. If your end goal is to export a character from Blender and use it somewhere else, then you will most likely want to use the game engine material. If you want to render close-ups in cycles, then you might want to consider the multi-layered skin model. However, using the multi-layered model in combination with EV will probably cause Blender to freeze, or at least become very sluggish to work with. The later videos in the series will go into more detail about the various material models. For now, we will simply note that they are there and that you can pick amongst them to achieve various effects. Which brings us down to practice. As said, if you have not chosen otherwise, then all materials will use the Make Skin material model. You can change this on the Apply Assets panel. Or, if you have already created a character, then you can override the material model when loading it. Let's start by creating a character. Next, we can load a skin. Since we have not changed the default, we will get the image-based Make Skin material model. As we can see, we get the basic colors of a skin, but there is no variation in surface texture. Going to the Texture Paint tab, we can see that the material consists of a single image texture with a color. And in the Shader tab, we can see there is a simple node setup with a single image. Now let's change the skin material model to multi-layered. The skin won't change until the next time we apply a new skin. Having applied it, we see that we get a more detailed surface with bump mapping and roughness variation. These aspects have been added using procedural logic. The node setup of the multi-layered skin is rather complicated. It will be covered in more detail in a later part of the series. The material models to use can also be adjusted when loading a character. In the final part of the video, I'd just like to mention that there are asset packs with materials. If you have not already done so, you could download the extra materials for the system assets. There are both materials for the system clothes and for hair. These are installed in the same way as the other asset packs. Having installed the pack, we get new options for alternate materials. Anyway, this concludes the first part of the series on materials. Thank you for watching and happy modeling.